Hey everyone, Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager for Microsoft Fabric. In this video, we'll be sharing demos for modeling and mobile, two of my favorite Power BI topics. These demos are packed with such great information, from how to create semantic models in Direct Lake storage mode in Power BI Desktop, that's gotta be an exciting one, probably one of my favorites, to updates for modeling in the web, then how do you view reports linked directly to a semantic model on your mobile device using Power BI Mobile? Well, you gotta watch this demo and a few other demos in there that you should just check out. But to get started, let's hand it off to Zoe. Zoe, take it away.
We are excited to announce the public preview of creating Direct Lake semantic models in Power BI Desktop. First, you need to enable the preview feature in the options menu. With this feature enabled, the Connect button in the OneLake catalog will have new actions. The primary Connect action on a lakehouse is to add Direct Lake tables, and the primary Connect action on a SQL endpoint is to add import or direct query tables, offering you the flexibility to use your fabric data in the OneLake however you choose. When I go to OneLake catalog and pick a lakehouse or warehouse, I can add tables in Direct Lake mode from the OneLake. This Direct Lake mode is a little different from the Direct Lake mode you have when you create these off the SQL endpoint in the web. This Direct Lake is without fallback and separate from the SQL endpoint. Here I can give my semantic model a name and pick the tables I want to add, and when I click OK, the semantic model is created in the chosen workspace, and I am now live editing the model in Power BI Desktop. I can create relationships between the tables by dragging and dropping columns. Assume referential integrity here now removes the blank option that may show in slicers for Direct Lake models. This Direct Lake model also allows multi-source. I can return to the OneLake catalog and pick another lakehouse or warehouse and bring in tables from there as well. This is similar to an import model where I can bring in tables from multiple sources. And I can create additional relationships between the tables from the OneLake. Here, I want to always double-check the relationship properties carefully. In Direct Lake, no data preview is shown when you're creating relationships, and the cardinality and cross-filter direction are pre-populated with default values. There is no automatic validation of cardinality and cross-filter direction like in import models. Cardinality is always set to many to one, and cross-filter direction is always set to single. When creating relationships, be sure to manually validate that these properties are appropriate to the relationships you are creating and adjust as needed. And if I want to see all the data sources I have added, just like for import models, I would go to the data source settings. Here, a new button is added for Direct Lake, allowing you to return to the table picker via Edit Tables button. I can use DAX Query View to see the data in my tables and analyze it further, and Copilot is here to help me write DAX queries. I can also use TimbleView to script tables and edit all the properties with code. If I want to create a report to visualize this data from desktop, I can go to File, Blank Report to create another instance or window using Power BI Desktop on my computer. With multiple monitors, I can even edit my model on one screen and create my report on the other. To live connect and create the report only, just like I can with any published semantic model, I go to the OneLake catalog and choose the Power BI semantic model. This one, I just happen to also be live editing in another window. I can create visuals in a report like I can with any semantic model I'm live connected to. Here, I'm going to show the sum of sales by year in a simple line chart. The full interactivity and easy creation of visuals is available to Direct Lake semantic models. Copilot is also here to help me in report view by suggesting pages based on the semantic model I'm connected to. And when I'm ready, I can publish this report to the workspace and share it with others. So visualize your OneLake data today by creating Direct Lake semantic models in Power BI Desktop.
Previously, we added support for viewing semantic models in the Power BI mobile apps. This allowed users to track model status and trigger on-demand refreshes directly from the app. To view semantic model in a workspace, simply open the workspace and select the semantic models filter to access the semantic model info pane. Now we've taken it a step further. You can see which reports are connected to a semantic model directly from the app. To see the connected reports, select linked content from the semantic model info pane. you'll be able to see related reports you have access to, including those from different workspaces. The origin workspace of each report is shown below its name. Understanding which reports were created for a semantic model is crucial. It ensures the consistency and reliability of data across different reports. When users know their reports are linked to a common semantic model, they can trust that the metrics and calculations are standardized. This is particularly important in collaborative environments where multiple stakeholders rely on accurate data to make informed decisions. From here, you can select any report to open.
Starting this month, we are rolling out the users can edit data models in the Power BI service workspace level preview setting shown here to be turned on by default for pro workspaces. In January, we announced that this preview switch would be on by default for premium workspaces, and now this is the default setting for pro workspaces as well. This means that in both pro and premium workspaces, you can edit your semantic models immediately without needing to turn on the preview feature. If you prefer, you can still disable the workspace preview for your workspace, but we recommend keeping it enabled. Power BI administrators will still have the ability to enable or disable data model editing in the service for the entire organization or specific security groups through the admin portal.
You can now seamlessly open your DirectLake semantic models for editing in Power BI Desktop directly from the web. Just like in Office products, simply select the Edit in Desktop option from the web to launch Power BI Desktop with the same DirectLake model open and ready for editing. Here in Desktop, you can live edit your DirectLake model where all changes are instantly applied to the semantic model in the Fabric workspace without needing to select Save. Changes include all modeling tasks such as renaming tables or columns, adding or removing tables from the lakehouse, creating measures, and creating calculation groups. There's even full IntelliSense support in the DAX formula bar. DAX Query View is also available to run DAX queries to preview data and test measures before saving them to the model. You can find more details, including limitations and other aspects of live editing DirectLake models in Power BI Desktop within our documentation. In January, we announced the preview of semantic model version history for semantic models stored in premium workspaces. We are excited to share that just as we promised, this feature has now been extended to support pro workspaces as well. This means you can now use semantic model version history for your models edited on the web in both premium and pro workspaces. Let's take a look at how this feature works.
Here I am looking at a report in the service, and I notice that many of the visuals are broken, and this is not something I can share with my leadership team. I suspect something might be wrong with the underlying semantic model. So I open the semantic model in the web, and I notice that not only am I missing a relationship between these two tables, but I'm also missing the key column that would connect them. In the past, this would be really hard to get my model back to a working state, but thanks to version history, I can simply open an Office-like version history pane and pick a previous version of my model to restore to. So then, in the matter of only a few seconds, I am able to get my model back into a working state where I have that relationship and I have that column. So now, if I go back to my report and do a refresh, I see all the visuals working as expected. Restoring my model to a previous version was quick and easy and ready for me out of the box in an office-like experience, all thanks to the recently released public preview of Semantic Model Version History. You can find more details about limitations and other aspects of this experience within our documentation.
We have heard a lot of excitement across the Power BI community about the potential of using Semantic Link and Fabric Notebooks in various Power BI scenarios. We are thrilled to announce that we are making it even easier to get started with Fabric Notebooks and Semantic Link to analyze your semantic models on the web with one-click experiences. Simply choose one of our pre-configured notebooks, such as Best Practice Analyzer. We handle creating the notebook and do all the configurations for you so that it is ready to use against your semantic model and your workspace. All you need to do is select Run All to have the best practice analyzer run against your model. It will check a set of over 60 rules defined by experts within the Microsoft and Fabric community and summarize all of these results. You'll get suggestions on things like DAX expressions, formatting, maintenance, performance, and error prevention. Then you can easily use the multitask switcher to go back to your model and update it accordingly. We also support another pre-configured notebook called Memory Analyzer. If you select this notebook, we will again handle creating the notebook and all the configurations for you. By selecting Run All, you can see memory and storage statistics about the objects in your model. These statistics can be used to identify areas for performance optimization and memory reduction in your semantic model.
This provides a rich look into statistics for your tables, partitions, columns, relationships, and hierarchies, which you then can use to optimize your model by going back to the modeling experience in the web. We also provide entry points to open the Power BI Community Notebooks Gallery. Here you can explore and submit notebooks you've created to enhance your Power BI data analysis and reporting with the rest of the Power BI community. We are excited to offer a community-driven space to see all the innovative ways the community uses Semantic Link and notebooks for Power BI scenarios.
Wow, those were some fantastic demos. I'd love to hear what stood out to you the most. If you've got any questions, don't hesitate to drop them in the comments below. And hey, is there a particular demo you'd like us to tackle next month? Let us know. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to stay up to date with all our latest content. See you next month.